ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंशर्षभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृत दुहे नमः। माय बेस्ट विशेस एंड परिपूर्ण आशीर्वादम्स टू ऑल द व्यूवर्स। मे द ऑलमाइटी श्री लॉर्ड वेंकटेश्वरा बिस्टू ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी हेल्थ वेल्थ एंड इटर्नल हैप्पीनेस विद परिपूर्ण लक्ष्मी कटाक्षम्स टू यू एंड एंटायर योर फैमिली एंड फ्रेंड्स। लेट अस बिगिन भगवद्गीता वर्स नंबर 5 ऑफ 12th चैप्टर। श्री भगवान उवाच क्लेशोऽधिकतरस्तेषाम् अव्यक्तासक्तचेतसाम् अव्यक्ता हि गतिर्दुःखम् देहवद्भिरवाप्यते। भगवान कृष्ण टॉक्स अबाउट स्पिरिचुअल सीकर्स एंड डिफिकल्टीज विच आर फेस्ड बाय द सीकर्स। व्हाई ही टॉक्स हियर अबाउट स्पिरिचुअल सीकर्स? बिकॉज this chapter begins with Arjuna's question. What was the question? Arjuna just wants to know who is superior between saguna upasakas and nirguna upasakas. What he wants to know, which is superior bhakti, nirguna upasana or saguna upasana? What is saguna upasana? The person who worships God with name and form is called Saguna Upasakaha. And the person who worships Lord without name and form is known as Nirguna Upasakaha. The question itself is wrong, but Bhagavan doesn't deny it. He didn't reject your question is wrong, but he gave answer in different way so that Arjuna could understand better than before. As we saw in the last session, Bhagavan has established 5 steps as the bhakti marga. If we look into very deep, in one word, Bhagavan has specified whole spiritual activities. The whole spiritual activities from the chapter 1 to 11, whatever the activities are prescribed by Bhagavan himself, he has brought all of them in one topic called bhakti. Narada explains bhakti means pure love towards God. Bhagavan gives the meaning of bhakti, which is nothing but all activities of spiritual seeking or spirituality. Now we have to understand the glory of Krishna. Without bhakti, no spiritual activity will give completeness. Now a seeker must be aware about this thing. A bhakti is the only one very important thing in spiritual activities. First of all, we should know who is a seeker. And what is the difference between a seeker from a normal person? What are the differences are seen by us? What is the difference that he brings into his life, into his mind, than the normal person's life? A normal person lives life in easy way. Whatever the goal he wants to fix as the ultimate goal in his life, he fixes and he keeps on moving in that. But the spiritual seeker fixes. Moksha is the goal. Bhagavan is the goal. Both of them entirely differs with their goals. A normal person has the goal which is endowed with limited happiness. But the spiritual seeker fixes a goal which is endowed with unlimited happiness. But the normal person's life seems to be more easier than the spiritual person's life. Why is so? That's what Bhagavan is bringing here. Because they have to bring the discipline in their life. The spiritual life means there are disciplines which are prescribed. In the last words also we saw,
Sanniyamyendriyagramam sarvatra samabuddhayah te prapnuvanti mam eva sarvabhotahiteratah.
Te prapnuvanti mam te prapnuvanti. They attain me. Who? The people who have restrained their organs, who have got even minded, and who think for the welfare of human being, they alone can attain me. A normal person will be living with his selfishness. But this person has to grow, to become more matured. He should be with broad-minded. Therefore, it is entirely different aspects in our life. A seeker means who should be endowed with disciplines and who should be informed about bhakti. If you remove bhakti from any spiritual activities, those activities won't bring completeness. Bhakti means love according to Narada. Bhakti means spiritual according to Bhagavan Krishna. The love to be practiced with Bhagavan. Bhagavan has launched 5 steps from Karma Yoga to Jnana Yoga. In between Upasana Yoga, as we learnt, bhakti means 3 aspects. Karma based bhakti, Upasana based bhakti, Jnana based bhakti. We should not forget it. And this definition is the complete definition of bhakti. The topic of spiritual seekers and difficulties are brought by Bhagavan Krishna to bring more understanding in Arjuna's mind regarding the spiritual life, regarding the 5 steps. So when a normal person wants to convert himself to be a spiritual seeker, he should learn how to surrender. If a person wants to become a seeker, somebody says, you should know how to surrender. Immediately he goes to a temple and he does Sashtanga Namaskara by saying that I am surrendering completely to you. Can you say the complete surrendering will take place in that point? No. He has begun to practice surrendering. At that time, complete surrendering has not taken place, but he has to continue with. That's what the spiritual life must be began with surrendering. The spiritual life ends with complete surrendering. That's all. Now, bhakti means what? Surrendering. This is the style of Krishna. You know. Now, surrendering had happened with Arjuna. In the first chapter itself, he is continuing with the surrendering. First 6 chapters, he learned what exactly Karma Yoga. There are 2 kinds of Karma Yoga, Sakama Karma Yoga and Nishkama Karma Yoga. Sakama Karma Yoga will give the ability a person to grow to be a Nishkama Karma Yogi. And Sakama Karma Yoga means with surrendering. Surrendering means bhakti. Surrendering is only possible when you have love towards Ishvara. Now, we have to understand the spiritual life should be began with the Karma Yoga, having surrendered Lord's Padaravinda. And then you will be achieving the stages. Karma Yoga to Nishkama Karma Yoga. From Nishkama Karma Yoga to Upasana Karma Yoga, Upasana Yogi. Now, Upasana means what? Completely you are concentrated, focused, in spiritual activities. That we have explained a lot in the last session. We have seen what is the meaning of upasana marga. Upasana means a mental meditation. Bhagavan says, the spiritual practices are difficult. When a seeker makes efforts to convert himself to be a spiritual seeker, he finds certain kinds of difficulties. His minds are not trained. He faces some kind of difficulties. Therefore, in the fourth chapter itself, Bhagavan said, Manushyanam sagasreshu kaschit yatati siddhaye tatamapi siddhanam kaschin mam veti tatvataha. There are so many people make effort to become spiritual seekers. They seek the truth. But one among those kind of thousands of people will get what he is seeking for. Therefore, he finds certain kind of difficulties in the beginning. Then he also continues with certain kind of difficulties in between. Then finally, when he comes to the Jnana Yoga, he will find great difficulties. That's what he brings, you know, kleshaha adhikataraha, great difficulties. Because this is entirely new and it's very strange for a mind to ask that to think about something which is not having name and form. When you are having saguna upasana, it's very easy. You can adore and admire Lord Krishna's form. You are able to communicate easily. You can have a love towards Krishna. You can admire him by having archana, puja, shodasupachara and everything. If you are asked, means if we are asked to think Krishna without name and form, our mind will get stuck. So how it is possible? Then you need more teaching, more meditation, more analysis. Now Krishna is not going to continue in the same form forever. Now Krishna is not seen. Krishna's contemporary was something different. Now still people, Saguna Brahma Upasana people are having Krishna as the Upasana Murti. Where is Krishna now? The Krishna who is in the form of cause of everything. Then you have to analyze in the form of cause and effect theory. This is how people should be able to bring the Nirguna Upasana. It takes time. It takes long time. Arjuna also faces the same difficulties. Therefore he asks, you know, who is superior? Saguna Brahma Upasaka or Nirguna Brahma Upasaka means what? He is not able to find the way in through which he can find the Nirguna Upasana. It's very difficult. You have to be complete mature enough. And Bhagavan, he specifies more. There are greater difficulties to those people whose mind are committed to the pursuit of the unmanifested Brahman. That's what the meaning of avyakta sakta chetasam. The people who are committed in the form of Nirguna Upasana, they find more difficult. Why? Because they have bodily consciousness. We can say the attachment with the body. The attachment with the body won't allow a Saguna Brahma Upasaka to become a Nirguna Brahma Upasaka. It's very difficult. Therefore, you know, mind won't accept. So it always likes to worship Lord with form. Lord with form means as a Krishna, as Rama, as even, you know, any deity he wants to take, Lord Ganesha, Lord Kartikeya. So all of them seems to be joyful worship. If you remove all the names and forms, mind won't get any taste. It is said Nirguna Upasana means a God who is Ashabda Rupa, arasaha, asaga, agandha. God doesn't have, you know, any kind of color, form, taste, nothing. then your mind becomes interestless. You won't be interested to meditate on Nirguna Ishwara. All these things are because of what? Deha Vadbhihi, the attachment towards the body. We want to precise, we want to compress, or we want to bring Bhagavan into compact form, in a human form, for our convenient. But that is not the final stage. Bhakti means what? You have to grow to get Nirguna Tattva. To get explored with Nirguna Tattva. Nirguna Tattva is the supreme Bhakti. So Bhagavan himself, he is very clear about it. Therefore he talks about the seeker. Arjuna has become a real seeker now. In the beginning he was blabbering something, but now he is not. The bhakti has to be understood completely. Bhakti, which is in the form of pure love, which is also in the form of all the means of moksha. I mean all the spiritual activities are called bhakti alone. Therefore this chapter is kept as the 12th chapter. Otherwise, Bhagavan might have kept this chapter in the beginning itself. Why Bhagavan didn't start with Bhakti Yoga to Arjuna? Because in order to realize what exactly Bhakti, you need to have more information, more understanding about God, world and the life. Therefore, he took 11 chapters for that. Therefore, he says, so tesham avyakta chetasam kleshaha adhikataraha avyakta hi gatir dukham. One cannot fix this nirguna as goal at all. It seems to be, you know, completely meaningless to the people who are endowed with bodily attachment. Bhagavan specifies, you know, who are the Saguna Brahma Upasakas? Why they are not able to convert to become a Nirguna Upasaka? It's very difficult. Then in the next verse, Bhagavan Krishna continues about Saguna Upasana. Let us read it. Yeto sarvani karmani mayi sanyasya matparaha ananye naiva yogena mam dhyayanta upasate. So after completing 5th chapter, Bhagavan Krishna begins from the beginning of Bhakti Yoga. As we saw the 5 steps, you know, he starts from Karma Yoga. Any spiritual seeking begins with surrendering. That's what I have told now. The same thing, the surrendering should begin with Karma Yoga. See, yetu sarvani karmani mayi sanyasya matparaha ananyena yogena mam dhyayante. The people who meditate, who worship me with dedication, ananya bhakti, having surrendered their karmas, their karma phalas. Didn't I tell you in the beginning of this verse? So when you begin the spiritual life, you should begin with surrendering. Sanyastya means doing arpana to the Lord. How to surrender? We have to learn how to surrender. Therefore, just go and do sashtanga namaskara every day. Whoever the deity you select, then start saying, you know, I am surrendering to you. I am surrendering to every day. You practice it. And many people are not able to even lie down for surrendering. The surrendering only will take place when you do sashtanga namaskara. Every day you have to practice. That physical practice will bring slowly some kind of understanding. It will help for us to grow. That's what the activities our forefathers have given. Sarvani karmani mahi sanyasya. Not only doing namaskara. Whatever you do, you start thinking that I am offering to him. I am offering to him. I am offering to him. Every day you should go in front of the deity and you should look at the deity with the love and affection. We have to bring the love and affection. First you may not get. Therefore, we have to study about Krishna. When you study about Krishna, automatically the mind will explore love and affection. We have to study Srimad Bhagavatam. In order to get the love, in order to get the affection, because in order to surrender, you need to have love and affection towards God. Otherwise, you cannot surrender. The respect, love and affection should be generated. You have to work for it. I mean, you have to make effort for it to generate the love and affection. Once you are finding love and affection with the form of the God, you are able to surrender. Now you can practice every day, every evening you can go in front of the deity and you can utter the word, I am surrendering everything what I did today. That is the surrendering. You begin like that. Slowly, you know, when you surrender, your mind will decrease the tension. Your mind will become more calm, more peace. You can feel the tranquility in your mind. That's what Bhagavan says, Matparaha Bhava. In another place, Manmana Bhava, Madbhakto Bhava, Madhyaji Bhava. He's going to say, Matparaha. You have to fix me as the goal. But it is not possible in the beginning itself. You have to grow. So now Bhagavan is the goal. You have to understand that Bhagavan can be the proper goal. For a seeker who is in the form of a devotee, who learns to surrender and who is able to fix God alone is the ultimate goal. Therefore, I am surrendering to him. The surrendering is a long practice, you know. You need years to surrender everything. So merely you begin uttering the word, slowly the surrendering will take place. Then that surrendering will allow, will make you to fix God as the ultimate goal, and it will bring ananya bhakti. Ananya bhakti means what? Your mind will be focused with that particular form. That's what Saguna Brahma Upasana. It's a beautiful way. You can study about Mirabai and you can study about all the people, bhaktas who are mentioned in Sri Bhakta Vijayam, Sri Mahabhakta Vijayam. You study Srimad Bhagavatam. So when you study all of them, you will find the what is Ananya Bhakti. And finally you yourself will understand, you know, we have to catch hold only the feet of Lord, not anything else. That is the understanding. Then what? Your surrendering has begun inside. It may take long years, doesn't matter. Don't give up your confidence. You need not to give up at all. Then the next words, Tesha maham samudharta mrityu samsara sagarat bhavam inachirat partha mayyaveshita chetasam. When we surrender, God becomes aware. He becomes more conscious about ourselves. The people who doesn't worry about God, who doesn't practice surrender, who doesn't fix Bhagavan as ultimate goal, Bhagavan is not talking about them. Bhagavan is talking about the real seeker who is practicing surrender and who is fixing Bhagavan himself as the goal. Now Bhagavan says, Thesham, to those people, to those seekers, I become Samudharta. I am the protector. I am the savior to them. It means what? It's a pramana for us. And I save them from samsara ocean. Mrityu samsara sagarat, the ocean of death. I rescue them from the ocean of difficulties. Not only that too soon, not, you know, in thousands of years, once in a thousands of years. Like, you know, sambhavami yuge yuge. That word even is to be understood properly. When Bhagavan says, in every yuga, I make myself into manifested form. Not in every yuga. When a bhakta surrenders, Bhagavan becomes more conscious about him. The truth is, Bhagavan exists everywhere. Not understanding that fact, the beginners of spiritual life, they start surrendering. It means what? The surrendering is observed by God being in their own form or being in their mind and buddhi. Bhagavan becomes very aware and consciousness, and he becomes very responsible person towards them. Therefore he says, aham samuddharta. You have to know this word. He becomes the protector, savior. He will take care of everything. It means what? Your surrendering is valid by Bhagavan and also assured by him to get rid of all kinds of karma bandha. That's what Saguna Brahma Upasana. It's known as Ekarupa Bhakti or Anekarupa Bhakti. Doesn't matter. The names are different. But Bhakti is a Bhakti. Bhakti means what I mean to say here. The activities which are in the form of surrendering, loaded with abundance of love towards God, is called Bhakti. You study about every Bhakta's history. You study about Tukaram, Jnaneshwar, you study of Ramanuja, or you study of all the Acharyas. You study about Nammal words, you will come to know what exactly the Bhakti is. You need not to study of their history. You just study what they have written. You have to study, if you know a little bit Sanskrit or Tamil, you can enjoy that. All this, the Pasurams which was written by Nammalvar. It's beautiful. All these devotional songs which are in the form of Devaram, Thiruvachakam, and so many, Tyaga Brahmam has given all kinds of devotional song, Carnatic song, you can enjoy. That's what Bhakti Rasam. In one place, Tyaga Brahmam says, Pibare Rama Rasam. When you utter the name of the Rama, you can experience the sweetness in your mouth. Therefore, I said, you know, studying the history of the Bhaktas is one way to looking into Bhakti. But Bhagavan Krishna, he being a Lord, he teaches directly what is Bhakti. He is very clear about it. We have to have a little bit more patience and a little bit more surrendering attitude towards his teaching. Now he has taught from the last words. He said, you know, the spiritual activities should be began with surrendering, sharanagati. That sharanagati which is loaded with ananya bhakti, he means what? Complete love, pure love towards God. That bhakti should be endowed with knowledge of the God. That's also very important, you know. That knowledge which is from Shastra. Now, the spiritual knowledge and love towards Ishvara both helps us to surrender ourselves properly to the Ishvara. Then what? The spiritual life begins. And the assurance also given by Lord, Bhagavan himself. The next words. Maye vamana adhatsva maye buddhim niveshaya nivashishyasi maye va ata udvam na samshayaha. Udvam na samshayaha. Definitely you will reach the goal. Don't worry. Bhagavan says that we will see from the next session. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate
ओम शांति 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 हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम।